We work so you can play.
Hey there, Mini Wargamers. Mini Wargaming Paul here to show you the new Orc Plastic Killicans. These are awesome models, and just going to walk you through my build and painting of them. First off, the thing that you probably already know, but I thought was absolutely amazing when I first heard, is you get three of them. Three plastic Killicans in a box. In the olden days, you know, you used to get one metal one. Anybody who's built one of those knows how hard they were to build and pretty much impossible. Well, maybe not impossible, but difficult to magnetize. These guys were super easy to build and super easy to magnetize, which is great because you can have them on the tabletop almost right away. The price is right for three of them, but hey, that's your decision. I thought it was great. So anyways, let's walk through it. Oh, I got a visitor. Let's first look at the magnetization of these. The Killicans, obviously plastic is one of the great things, one of the easy things to magnetize. These guys here, comes with two arms. So here's your base Killican. When you buy it in the Codex, it comes with one close combat arm. Then your options are to buy it a weapon of whatever sort. So here's the rocket arm and magnetize it, there you go. Killican with rockets. If you don't like that, take that off. Got a Killican with a Scorcha. Although I don't know why you put a Scorch on a Killican, you got Gretchen and they're your best shooters in your army. So that's one of the great things about Killicans is you've got Gretchen pilots in here. So you have a ballistic skill of 3, which for orcs is absolutely amazing. Their weapon skill, not so good. So the close combat arms might be good for taking out some vehicles or something like that, or if you have a big mob that you want to throw them in there with. But really, these are shooty and they're armored because they're orcs. Your Killican package will come with 3 bodies that have various different options on them here. You'll see that they all have different fronts, they all have different backs. The pictures will show that a bit better. There'll be some interspersed in this video, and also you can check my channel. There's an article all about that, lots of pictures. So everything is interchangeable. You got three different sets of legs, 3 sets of fronts, 3 tops, and 3 backs, and 3 sets of sides. And what I did is I just cut them all out, put them in a pile, and just kept grabbing different ones. Everything is interchangeable, which is great. You can have, if you had, say, 3 mobs of 3 Killicans in your army, which is a pretty competitive build, you could have them all kind of built a little bit differently and help make them look orky because they're not all exactly the same. So as you can see here, I've magnetized each of them. Got magnets in the arm socket there. Same as the Death Dread, these are ball joints, which may not be quite as easy to magnetize as, say, the Assault on Blackreach Dreadnought, which you don't really need to magnetize, you just stick the arms on. But it is quite easy. I used a 1/16 inch drill bit, drilled a small pilot hole in the middle, and obviously because it's a ball, the drill finds the center very easily. And then I drilled a 3/16 hole around that and glued a magnet in. Now, I made sure the magnets on all of these faced the same direction. So that means all the arms are interchangeable with all of them. Same with the Death Dread, because some of the weapon choices are the same. So make sure everything's the same. And in fact, I've done the same thing across my whole orc army to make sure that if I ever want to swap out weapons, if they fit, then I can use them. Obviously, each one of these guys is going to have a close combat arm. And your box will come with 3 arms and 4 ends to the arm. You got some buzzsaw type things, you got some claws, and you have this spiral drilly thing, which looks a lot like the conversion Mike did last year. There's a video about that. Check the archives. Anyways, maybe they copied him. He did a conversion of Assault on Blackreach Dreadnought, made it an Orc Death Dread. Looks a lot like this. I think GW's been spying on Mike. So you have a bunch of weapons. Comes with 4 weapons in the box. You have almost one of each option. You have Scorcha, a Grotzuka, which there was never a weapon for previously. It's really cool. It's got it's basically a scrap gun. It's got this hopper at the top, and it's full of scrap bits sticking out. You got some wrenches and whatnot, and it's just a big cannon that shoots that. That's actually a really good weapon choice for your Killicans. So you get one of those, you get a big shooter, and you get a rocket launcher. So it's got 3 little rockets on there. Again, much like the Death Dread, I painted these up in kind of a goth color scheme. Got some checkered pattern here and there, mostly black with some red. So again, with orcs, this always works well for me. Spray paint everything with flat black spray paint to start off with. So I sprayed it all black, and then I went and picked out the parts I wanted red. So in this guy here, you can see he's got that thing hanging below him there. He's got some of these hoses and these plates here I did red. And on the arm, the hoses, I kind of picked out an even number of things on each one of them, so they kind of looked like they belonged together, but weren't exactly the same. So started off by airbrushing those nose with a darker red color. Again, I like to use the airbrush because it's nice and fast, gives me a nice technique. However, you could easily do that with like Mechorite Red or Reaper Deep Red. Those are the two choices I would use instead of that. And then some washes after to kind of bring in the shading. And then I highlighted this with GW Blood Red after to help make it a little brighter, a little bit more pop. Once that was done, I moved over to the metal areas. So Bolt Gun Metal Base. So this thing here you can see there. Nice Bolt Gun Metal makes a really good base for metal colors. And then some maybe black wash or Devlin Mud works well too. Once that was done, I moved over to the white areas. And that's Calthron Brown from the foundation set. Put Bleach Bone on top of that and Skull White, just sort of little edge highlights. Kind of thin layer of that because I don't want it to look too white and look dirty. So these, most of them have kind of sort of a face on them. And I wanted to emphasize that. So I painted the teeth kind of white-ish. This one here as well. So once the white areas were in, or these tusks, I did the same thing. I added some washes there. I didn't blend it very nicely, but there you go. Once those were done, I moved on to the checkers. So those are base coated with black and Astronomicon gray. So it's a light gray. If you don't have that one, I guess you could use Codex gray. Yeah, or something like that. Anyways, a nice light gray, watered it down lots, painted on really fine brush, did the grid pattern, and then filled in, you know, alternating squares. And I went over that with Skull White to sort of bring out some of the edges and make it look a little bit brighter. Not too bright because it's orky and it's going to be dirty and messy and that kind of thing. Again, my army has a little bit of checker pattern and everything, so this kind of ties everything together. Makes it look a little bit more unified on the battlefield. Once that was done, I added a couple of little yellow bits around these eyes. You can kind of see it in there. It's a little bit yellow in the middle. Added some of the glyph plates, I did some yellow on just to bring it out. I tried to put some decals on these, some of the orc decals, but there's very, very little surface put anything on. There's a couple little panels that I could have, like this one here, I painted that yellow. I think I planned on putting a decal on there, but never did. Yeah, so there's not really that many flat surfaces on these guys to put any other details. So, oh, there's one right there, a little lightning bolt. Not really required, but small stuff like that, you know, kind of makes things look a little nicer. Then the last thing to do is the weathering. Exactly the same as what I did for the Death Dread. Used a heavy dry brush, I call it that, kind of brushed, pulled it across the edges of Reaper Rust Brown. Now, sometimes I've used a stippling of GW Blaze Orange, but I find the Reaper Rust Brown goes on really nice. You can put it on a bit thicker. The Blaze Orange, you gotta put on really thin, because obviously if it's bright orange, it's not gonna look quite as real, 40,000 years in the future, real. Matters, I guess. Yeah, so the Reaper Rust Brown's really nice, if you can pick that up or not. And then I use the GW Chainmail Silver to kind of, same idea, but just a little bit less. So you have rust there and then silver kind of on top of that. Now, in the past, I've used GW Tin Bits, which is also a good choice. I didn't use it at all on these ones, just because. And sometimes if I have time, I'll go over just this really fine edges with Mithril Silver. Again, I didn't do that on these, but I find that kind of makes things pop a little bit more, brings out the detail. Which is nice sometimes. So yeah, here's the Killikans magnetized, and anybody who's built these before, they go together so easy and so fast. I think in total to assemble and magnetize all three of these, I spent about 2 hours. I think the Death Dread took me about an hour and a half, and these guys a little bit longer just because there's three of them. This is gonna look awesome on the table. They're plastic, so they're not gonna fall apart on me and they're not gonna get paint chip. And the poses are great. You can mix it up a little bit more than I did, kind of plain, and maybe put a grot out of the top or something like that. Anyways, hope you enjoyed it. Check out the channel for some other ones, more pictures and explanation. And if you have any questions, feel free to post a comment or send me a message in the war mail stuff on miniwargaming.com. Thanks a lot. Take care.